the Star Wars fans on FlyGuy.net figure review. We're giving Darth Vader a little bit of love this time and catching up on some requests. This time is one for the, in fact you can't even see that because the focus is out, Battle Damaged Darth Vader. This, as you can tell, is part of the expanded universe, but is really from the Force Unleashed video game. And this was a figure that came out, it also came out on a kind of legacy card a couple of years back. Pretty hard to find now in many places, and a lot of people have really requested, they wanted to get hold of this, so I'm hoping one day we can maybe get to see this back in the Saga Legends as a bit of a variety for Darth Vader fans, but kind of an unusual figure in some ways, with a couple of cool features on it, very much like a Darth Vader that we just reviewed, the Darth Vader Infinities comic pack, which I should have mentioned comes with a removable chest plate. As does this guy here. There's some removable parts quite pretty much all over this figure. So first of all, let me just get the basic lightsaber reviewed and out the way. Very similar to the Infinities one, which I should have shown you, but bog standard lightsaber really, or Darth Saber, not much to it. However, on to the rest of the figure, lots of detail and things start to come apart in this figure. Number one is the helmet, and as you'll see underneath there, we've got a part of a helmet. And this exposes the Anakin's face underneath this battle damaged part of Darth Vader. So some other components that come off and fall off the figure itself is this chest plate, as I mentioned. Let me try and take this off, a little hard to do that while I'm looking away, but there we go. That comes off, and you'll see there's a peg there to hold that chest plate piece in play. So you get to see some exposure underneath of wires and flesh and all the kind of lovely parts there on Anakin's head, I should have pointed out. Let me just show you the back of that. Lots of scars and wires from the helmet. Some real damage on this guy. He really does take some beating. That's one thing about Darth Vader in certainly The Force Unleashed and other video games. He seems to take quite a beating in many, many ways. So another part of his armour, and again that clips on, you'll see the small peg there, and that clips onto that chest plate. So some of the features and things that come apart are part of a kind of gauntlet on his sleeve. Take that away and you expose yet more of the metal underneath. Let me just show you a little more, bend that round to just get a better look. So there we go, it just exposes the metallic arm. And that's it, so that fits on pretty much onto there. The other aspect is the kind of shin guard. There is no foot for the figure, there's not one as far as I've ever seen it anyway. So that's pretty much all you get in that aspect, but you take off the shin guard and it exposes again the part of Anakin's leg that he gets chopped off. Nice touch, you can just make out there is the kind of metallic pins which you briefly see in Revenge of the Sith, and they plug into Anakin's stumpy leg, and you get this very cool Terminator like robotic foot, super articulated too, which is cool. And it's very cool, it's very nicely done, gold and chrome paint and other bits and pieces. Plastic kind of ruined cape at the back. You can just see some aspects of the figure underneath. Pretty much solid black, there's no wires and cables. So there's this part of the damaged cape and it's all solid plastic. And also, as you'll see, his cape is very moth-eaten. And let me show this a little better. Full of holes. Throughout there, so obviously some wounds and blasts that have taken that out. That's the idea anyway. And that's pretty much that figure. There's nothing else I don't think that is removable from him. That's all fixed on, yep. But we still do get quite a fair bit of articulation on this guy. You've got a swivel head, ball-jointed shoulders, ball-jointed elbows, and swivel wrists. Or swivel gauntlets, I should say. Swivel waist. Swivel hips, my apologies. Ball jointed knees, and you do get these articulated ankles, so you really can pose this guy into just about any position you want. But he's really, he's very battle damaged. Maybe some would say a little bit too battle damaged to still be around. But nice touches from the paint. You'll see all these wires on the belt and around on the other side there, the paintwork. It's pretty well done, and the paint has certainly been lovingly applied. One of the cooler figures that came out in that Force Unleashed wave, I think it was the Legacy Collection, sorry, the 30th Anniversary Collection, I believe, that had the Force Unleashed figures, and then this was re-released as part of the just the Legacy Collection. But look, a cool one if you're into Vaders, and again, if all these people keep saying to me, why did you not give any love to Vader in some of the figures? Not true, I do have some, it's just the older figures, and I've never really... We've not seen much variety in Darth Vader over the years, so... There you go, let us know what you think. Did you like this figure? Would you collect and pick it up? Comment below, or as usual on facebook.com/flyguy.net. Join us over there and tell us what you think. See you for another Darth Vader review real soon. Cheers.